Mr. President, it was my pleasure to welcome you to the seat of the European Council today. We had a very fruitful exchange of views on the development and enhancing of the EU-Georgian relations and on a number of regional issues of common concern. We welcome the progress made so far in strengthening EU-Georgian relations after the launch of the association agreement negotiations in July. And I expressed my appreciation to the President for the Georgian side's preparedness and pragmatic approach. We agreed on the need to further advance the necessary reforms that would bring Georgian legislation in line with the EU in key areas. We also agreed that both the visa facilitation and readmission agreements should enter into force soon. The strengthening of the EU-Georgia relationship will be a further stimulus to Georgia to continue on reforms. The European Union has always been consistent on emphasizing the importance of shared values as referred to in the Eastern Partnership and for the conclusion of the association agreement. Georgia has achieved substantial progress in this field, and this must be recognized. Our expectation is that the process of consolidating democratic institutions should continue. In this framework, the new constitution and electoral reform will be an important benchmark. I underline the European Union's continuing full support for the security, the stability, sovereignty, and territorial integrity of Georgia. We expect the entire international community to do so as well. I confirm to the President the commitment of the Union to continue to be fully engaged in conflict resolution efforts. We are already mobilizing several EU instruments for this purpose: the Geneva discussions, the EU monitoring mission, assistance to internally displaced persons, just to name a few. We also discussed questions of regional stability, particularly in light of the upcoming summit of the OSCE in December and the Eastern Partnership summit next May. We agreed that the only way to ensure lasting stability in the Southern Caucasus is by peaceful means and by the full mobilization of diplomatic and political efforts. This is an important message I intend to take to the summit in Astana as well. Finally, the question of energy and energy security. You will recall that the European Council intends to devote significant time to this issue early next year. The future of the EU's energy supply and energy security is, of course, linked with its neighborhood as well, including the countries of the Eastern Partnership and beyond. In this context, I recognize the constructive role Georgia plays in the development of energy transit routes. Mr. President, thank you for your visit.
Thank you, President. Thank you.